Welcome to the Study Samurai podcast, brought to you by studysamurai.com and the Study Samurai Library online resource. My name is Dr. Prue Salter, and along with my co-host, Rocky Biasi, we provide high school students and their teachers and parents all they need to achieve their personal best in the high school years. This episode is my top five habits for students. Recently, I was asked what I thought the top five habits were for students in their last year of school. So I came up with a list and then realized, wouldn't it be good if all students had these habits firmly entrenched before they even reached the senior years of school? So your challenge this year, no matter what your year level, is to help ensure these habits become embedded as part of your practice for learning, to help you become an effective learner at school in your career and personal life. Number one is to engage. Don't be a bystander. Instead, be an active participant in your own learning, taking responsibility for what you need to do to achieve your personal best. This means you involve yourself in all your lessons, you stay on task and participate. You complete all the work for your subjects and you seek help on anything that you can't do. Number two is to organize. Being organized means that you can find things when you need them, you don't forget about work to be done, and you don't have last minute panics. So this means you have a good system for managing all the paper for the school and for your digital resources. It also means when you're given an assessment, you make a plan for when you're going to do the work and you adjust the plan along the way as things change. Number three is to think ahead. Part of stepping up is that you don't just wait for someone to tell you to do something. You think ahead and work strategically. So if you know there's going to be exams, then don't wait till exam time to get your act together. Make your study notes as you go. Every time you finish a topic, make the study notes of that topic and file it away at home. Don't fall too behind in those study notes. Keep up to date and especially get up to date during the holidays. Number four is to strive for excellence. You want to be able to differentiate yourself from all the other students, so think what you can do to make your work stand out from the crowd. This means you take the time to be thorough when working on essays and assignments. It means lots of planning and brainstorming and then multiple drafts over a period of time. Number five is to study smart. Many students are incredibly ineffective in the way that they study. They just stare into their books, hoping what they need to learn will magically jump into their heads. But if you're going to study smart, it means you need to test yourself over and over on the material. You need to check for understanding. Can you apply the information by doing questions, past exam papers? Do you do the past exam papers under time limits? All of these things will make a big difference. That's all for today's episode of the Study Samurai podcast. Go to studysamurai.com for more episodes and resources, including a free presentation and more information about how your school or family can subscribe to the online Study Samurai library. Thank you.